of Honorable Kibuule. You might ask, what do we have in common? I met Honorable Kibuule in the middle of July 2011, after the general elections, when he had been nominated at the age of 27 to be a minister in the government of Uganda. For some reason, he thought my committee was going to reject him. So the day before the vetting, he spent time pacing in the corridor around my office. So eventually I told my secretary, tell that candidate that the vetting is tomorrow. He doesn't have to be here today. They said, no, but he says he wants to see you. So he came, and he said something very interesting. He said, do you think I will be approved by the committee? I said, I don't remember, I cannot answer that question today. You come back tomorrow, answer the questions confidently, the rest you leave to me. So here he is, he's our minister. But after that, This time is really, really hard. You don't know what to say under the circumstances. But I just want to add the testimony of other members. Some years back, in my family, a number of our children were involved in a motor accident. So the first one died on the first day. And as we were going to bury the first one, I got to Jinja and I was told the second one has also died. So it was a very, very difficult thing for us. It took us time to recover. I was fortunate, I was angry with God. I said, maybe one, but why two? But during the service, there is something the priest said. He said, you people are like flowers. God likes beautiful things. He likes beautiful flowers. That's why he's taking those two flowers. So, fortunately, and Ronald, those flowers God wanted. Those are the most beautiful. So please accept that that's the situation. But I would like to leave you with a small quotation from Thessalonians, chapter 5, verse 16 to 18. where we are told, be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for that is God's will for you in Jesus Christ. So give thanks for the short time you've had these children, give thanks for what has happened, give thanks also for the future. On behalf of Parliament, I bring very sincere condolences, and as you have been informed, we are still organizing ourselves. We shall come with a condolence message in a different way, but may God rest the souls of the young, our innocent flowers in eternal peace.